Hi, this is Melissa Dana, and this is First Look.
Hello, I'm Don Was, the president of Blue Note Records, and our guest on First Look this week is the mesmerizing saxophonist Melissa Aldana. She's a native of Santiago, Chile, and she comes from a musical family like her father and her grandfather. Melissa started playing saxophone in Santiago's jazz clubs as a young teenager. She then studied at Berklee College in Boston, and after graduation, she became the first female and the first South American to win the Thelonious Monk International Jazz Saxophone Competition. She's gone on to record three beautiful Grammy-nominated albums under her own name, and she was one of the founding members of the all-star collective Artemis that released its first album on Blue Note in 2020. Her exquisite new album, 12 Stars, marks her debut as a solo Blue Note artist. Thanks for being here today, Melissa.
Thank you so much for having me. It's such an honor to be part of this.
We're honored to have you on the label. 2020 was a tumultuous year for everybody on earth, but you had a lot of other stuff going on. Let's talk about the changes you went through and how it impacted the music that's on this album.
Yeah. So 2020, besides the pandemic and all the changes that were happening globally, I got separated. So I had big changes happening in my personal life. And, you know, I remember as the pandemic was coming, I was saying to myself, before the pandemic was coming, I was saying to myself that I wouldn't have time to really think about my issues or deal with myself, and I will just be busy practicing. And the pandemic hit, you know, and we all had to stop and had to spend a lot of time thinking and reflecting about who we are and the patterns and the way that we grew up, our relationships. So for me, it was basically that, you know, a very deep process of getting to know myself, which I think that is extremely related to the music.
Mm. You've got a stunning group of musicians for this album. Let's talk about the band a little bit.
Yeah. During the pandemic, I was very lucky that Pablo, my bass player, and Kush were living close to me. So I got to play with them basically once a week, and I got to try a lot of the music that we recorded on the album. And I know Kush from Berklee around like 10 years ago. And I know Pablo since I was 15 from Chile. And he's been the bass player that's been with me since I moved to New York. Mm-hmm. And then Lucky Loon is somebody that I started playing with around 4 years ago. I was doing a tour for my latest album, Visions, and my piano player couldn't play. And I'm always all about trying something that is completely different just to see how that is going to make me think about music differently. So I call Lager rather than using a piano player. And also, I really love his playing. And I'm a strong believer that in order to grow, you have to play with people that plays better than you. So I was lucky enough to get him. And then Sally Van Ferner, who I know for a long time, I got the chance to play a couple concerts with his band, and I know him. He's a close friend. So I got pretty lucky with the band.
It's an exquisite sound and record, and the playing is brilliant. The opening track on the album, Falling, is an incredible composition written by you and Lage. Your interplay with Sullivan goes so deep on it. Let's talk about Falling.
Yeah. Falling, the whole album has a storytelling. So it basically describes my journey. The name of the album is 12 Stars, and the 12 Stars, the journey is to finding my essence, which is connected to the third major kind of the tarot, which is the inspiration of the album. So Falling is when the pandemic hit, when I got separated, when everything just started falling apart, you know, and I tried to write a tune in relationship to every feeling that I was going through. So that's what you hear with the tune Falling. And then Lage actually arranged the tune. So a lot of the music, except for Intuition, I wrote most of it. I mean, I wrote everything, and then like he arranged it, and he was trying to find what is the personality of each tune.
Yeah, it's a great track. Let's play a little bit of it here, Falling. Thank you. That's Melissa Aldana from her new Blue Note release, 12 Stars, a track called Falling. Now, numerology and tarot figure into the title of the album and the song called 12 Stars. Tell us about that.
Yeah. You know, so I was going through a really deep process. You know, I've been into a lot of different kind of therapies and process to get to know yourself and understanding where you're coming from. And at some point, like, just nothing really made sense. And I wanted to also do something that was a little bit different, because I can easily be in a booth practicing 10 hours a day. And I always love visual art and the history of the symbols. I got really into Joseph Campbell and then Carl Jung, and then I started taking tarot lessons. And for me, more the divination part, the history of the tarot is really interesting, because it describes the history and the journey of a soul, you know, whatever that means in your time on earth or whatever. And I grew that tune inspired on each one of the major arcanas. And as I got into tarot, I got into numerology with tarot, therapeutic tarot, what is the name of the therapy that I was doing. And I found out that my essence is the third major arcana, which is the Empress, that has a 12 stars crown, you know, and 12 stars can mean a lot of different things in different cultures. You know, the connection with the universe, with the earth, love, motherhood, creation, you know. So basically the album talks about my essence, you know.
Beautiful. Well, let's play 12 Stars. That's Melissa Aldana, the title track from her new album, 12 Stars. The Bluest Eye is the title of one of the tracks on your album, as well as the title of Toni Morrison's first novel. What's the connection between the two?
Yeah, that is a book that Cecile recommended me. She was always sending me things that she was reading. And as I read the book, you know, the history, story of this little girl that was growing up during the Depression, you know, with this idea of, you know, what does it mean to be beautiful, you know, and this idea of like having the blue eyes, it meant beauty to her. And, you know, as a young female growing up in Chile, I remember, obviously, like, my experience wasn't the same, but I remember going to high school and all the girls was a thing to like buy fake blue eyes, you know, fake green eyes, you know. And in Chile, it's a very classist and racist, it can be a country, you know, and I remember growing up with this idea that the people had the money will have blue eyes and will be blonde, and the people with less money will be a little bit darker, you know, color skin. And I feel like this is a theme that resonates not just with back then with my childhood, but also as a grown up female, you know, and not just a musician, but as a female in this society, the idea of like how you have to look in order to be pretty, you know. And I think that is something that I can really relate to, and a lot of people can relate to, you know, regarding the gender as well.
Let's play that track, The Bluest Eye. That's The Bluest Eye from Melissa Aldana's new album, 12 Stars. Melissa, congratulations on this. It's a really vulnerable and expressive and elegant recording. It's an honor to have you recording for Blue Note. And we really want to thank you for being here with us today.
Thank you so much, Dan. The feeling is mutual.
Thank you. And thanks for watching First Look. We'll see you next time. If you enjoyed First Look and would like to see more, please hit the subscribe button and also click the bell icon. That way, you'll be notified when we post our next video.